Hello everyone, today I'm going to talk about one of the most commonly performed procedure on the hip joint, that is total hip replacement. As the name suggests, it involves replacing the entire hip joint which has got damaged because of one or the other kind of disease ailment. The most common causes of hip joint disease include traumatic, that is after hip fracture, which is either not managed properly or treated conservatively. The other reason could be avascular necrosis, and then rare causes are like infection of the hip joint, tuberculosis of the hip joint, and some autoimmune disorders also affect the hip joint to an extent wherein we need to replace the entire hip joint. Now here is a model which shows what is total hip replacement. If I show you the implant, so there is a particular implant which is used when we are doing total hip replacement. So implant has got primarily two components. One is the stem, which is called femoral stem. The other is the cup, which is called the acetabular cup. And you can see something white in this inside the center. That is a polyethylene liner, which helps in articulating with the head of the artificial joint. Like this. So this entire movement happens in this kind of circular motion, and this stem gets fixed inside the femoral stem, you can see, and this becomes the roof which goes into and fits into the pelvis. So the articulation of this with this becomes the total hip replacement. Now there are different types of joints. If you see this, the surface is hard and rough. So this is an uncemented implant wherein both the surfaces are rough, and natural osteointegration happens over a period of time. This is called uncemented total hip replacement. The other type of replacement is the cemented hip replacement, wherein both the surfaces are shiny and the bond between the bone and the implant is facilitated by a bone cement. Although various studies have proved that cemented also lasts for, many studies have completely proven beyond doubt that uncemented implants done nicely and fixed nicely can last longer than the cemented implant because of the wear properties of the cement over a long period of time. So no doubt the human joint provided by the God is the best joint, but whenever that joint becomes diseased due to any of the listed problems, then the second best option is a total hip replacement. And these days the type of implants which are available, if the hip replacement has been done properly and the patient has undergone adequate rehabilitation and physiotherapy, the patient can lead a very normal life for many decades to come. And due to the technology introduction in terms of robotics, minimally invasive anterior approach wherein the muscle sparing incisions are there, so that has helped make total hip replacement a very fast, safe and a reliable procedure for all those patients suffering from end stage hip diseases. Thank you so much.